Hi, welcome to YouTube Live. Sorry for the delay. We had some technical difficulties with the HDMI out, but we figured a way around it. So hopefully you guys get to see the demo. But I'm excited today because we have Skimble on. We have Marie and John with me, and they're going to tell us a little bit about their product, and then we're going to do some demos on a Nexus 10. Is that right?
That's right.
On an Android first app, from my understanding.
It is.
Yes.
Great, great. So let's dive into it since we're starting a little bit late. Let's start with the history of Skimble. Maria, do you want to tell me a little bit about that?
Sure. Thanks for having us. So first off, we wanted to make it as easy as possible to have people get fit and active wherever they are. And what's great about the proliferation of mobile devices is that people have their phones with them 24/7. So we really wanted to unleash the capabilities of the phone to help people live more active. We started Skimble with our applications basically to help ourselves train for the sports that we love. And from that grew now three different applications that help people live active. And the latest one is Fitness Flow, which we'll demonstrate today.
So you guys have a website too. So you have like a web app where you can sign up and do some stuff too. So you have a web app and a mobile app. Can you want to kind of talk about the differences between the two?
Sure. So what we offer is kind of a platform of applications that are fun and dynamic. They all kind of tie together on our website, and just newly launched for this year are web workouts that you can do from the big screen, your Mac or PC. The three different apps that we have right now are the Fitness Flow apps, the Fitness Flow app and Workout Trainer, as well as the GPS multi-sports tracking application. So as you track your different activities, whether it's a workout or a rock climb or a yoga session, it all kind of aggregates into your profile, and you can access that on your website, on the website.
Cool, and you can share this all socially, like what you're doing, and don't you get ranked or something by how many workouts you do?
Absolutely. So as you complete workouts, you gain activity points, and you get to rank on our monthly leaderboards against your friends, people nearby, and our global community.
Cool. One other interesting thing I saw on TechCrunch, an article about you guys, is you had some link with Harvard. There was something you were doing with that. Can you tell me about that?
Right. So what we do is we work with a big network of certified personal trainers, health professionals, and that actually includes the Harvard Medical School. So we're partnered with them to collaborate and create content for our applications. And specifically, our Workout Trainer app has a program called the Harvard Health Gym Coach. And you can unlock that in our app to basically get fit and get trained with a bunch of workouts customized for your busy life.
Okay, cool. Well, so, I mean, I'm excited about this. It helps you work out, especially if you're new to it. But I'm really excited because it's using our, you guys were one of our launch partners for the YouTube Android Player API, mm-hmm. Which is a native, if you guys don't know, it's a native API that you can use to allow you to play YouTube within your app without leaving and going to a separate app. So let's look at a demo because that always helps me. I'm more of a visual person. So let's have a look at the demo and then we'll talk about the technical details.
Sounds good. So I'll load this up over here. So as you get into the app, you can just click on the quick start button.
Bottom to bottom squats. These squats start and end at the bottom position. Stand with feet shoulder width apart, bend knees and ankles. Stand up and squat down, holding for a 1 second count each time at the bottom.
All right. Let's say we wanted to mix it up.
More sit-ups. Start on your back with your knees bent and feet flat on the floor. Place your hands palm down by your sides. Crunch up to 30 degrees with your left arm straight in front of you and your right elbow on the ground. At the top, twist your torso to the right and bring your left arm over to grasp your right elbow. Return to the starting position and then repeat, alternating sides.
So this is actually grabbing a bunch of YouTube videos, right, and putting them together and then flipping them out, right?
Right.
Start lying face down.
So as you can see, we're streaming videos from YouTube and displaying it on the big screen. When we have enough of one exercise, we can choose a bunch of other ones. We can even filter exercises. So for instance, if I want to just do body weight exercises that say work my core.
Alternating full side planks.
then it'll load the exercises that are customized for that specific body area.
Hold briefly, then return to the plank and twist to four.
Once I've had enough, I can get a summary of my workout, and in the history view, I can always do my workouts again. So it's kind of like a new workout every time, unlike maybe a traditional fitness DVD that can get stale fast. We offer hundreds of exercise videos which you can pick and choose from and go at your own pace to really have a customized workout experience every time.
That's great. That's great. So again, you guys are using the YouTube Android Player API. So do you want to tell us a little bit about the technical integration?
Sure. The challenge for us in building this app was that we really wanted to make something that was we think is more interactive than the typical YouTube app, because as you can see, we're playing the videos and we're looping them, and the sound isn't actually coming from the video, it's coming from a separate source. So we don't have to repeat the sound as we repeat the video. And we really wanted the videos to be driven by the user interaction rather than, say, the video's entire length. So that created a number of different challenges for us. The YouTube API has been really simple, very straightforward to use. So we just load the video, and then we take a lot of advantage of all the different video callbacks you get. Like there's a video started callback, a playing, a paused, and that lets us cue the timer that records how long you've been doing things, and there's an on-ended callback that we can use to start looping the video again. And then we we monitor that state, and as we see the video is progressing, we play the different sounds that correspond to the stage of the workout you're in.
Great. Now, what part of the Player API? Because we have different versions. We have like a full one that'll pop up. We have an example of all this, like a wall and everything. We have like fragment versions. Which particular one did you use?
This is just the the YouTube player view. And then we also take advantage of the thumbnail views for the list views you can see on the side there. Those are all thumbnail views.
Oh, great. So you have a couple of them running.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I guess what I always like to ask was, the obvious something we always ask is what language you did, but obviously use Java because that's all you can use with the Android Player API. But did you see any sort of and did anything surprise you when you started integrating? Now, that said, you guys did start early in the beta period,
right.
So you gave us a lot of feedback, which is great. But anything actually, even during that period, that surprised you as you were going along?
No, I mean, to be honest, well, to me, surprise is sort of a bad word when you're dealing with working on a project.
Yeah.
Everything. There's some moderate changes through the course as you guys progress towards the actual. The launched version of it, but no, everything was really straightforward. I thought it worked very smoothly to be integrated into the app.
I guess I should have said counterintuitive. but no,
not that I can think of at the top of my head. It was it's for the functionality you get, it's really a pretty limited set of things you have to pick up. Just a few basic. Objects, and then and play a video, show a thumbnail. It's all pretty straightforward.
Pretty straightforward, great.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's good to hear. So we always like to ask, are there any features that you'd like to see in the product? And I know you at least mentioned one offline, which you're welcome to mention again. You were talking about you're hoping to eventually release, because this is actually, people don't know this, but this is an Android first app,
right?
And for you guys to do everything that you need to do, you need a pretty low level of control with the YouTube Player API, correct? So, I think you were saying you're looking for an iOS version of this as well.
Yeah, we'd love to see an iOS version of the Android API.
We're always looking.
Or the YouTube Android API.
No
pressure.
We've heard that before, and. I always like to, bring it up and at least hear all the feedback. But we've definitely heard that, so we hear the feedback, and we're looking to it in as much as we can.
Right.
Just to add to that, I think overall the experience working with the API has been fantastic, and we really like being able to stream our exercise videos. They're HD in quality, so you know bandwidth is sort of a concern for us. So what I'd love to see would be an even slicker way to provide our streaming experience in areas where the bandwidth might be a little lower, or the connectivity has a, you know, you might have some issues with connectivity. We also provide an offline mode setting, which provides all the audio coaching, timing cues, and motivational messages sans the video itself. So being able to manage the experience and providing an optimal experience for areas or times when you have high bandwidth and also lower and even none.
Okay. Well, that's a good suggestion. Mm-hmm. I'll definitely take that back to the team. We usually like to traditionally open up to see if we have any questions. I'll see if anybody's asking anything. There's a question. Well, there's a question about I/O, and obviously, just keep an eye on our I/O site if you want to join and go to that. There is a bug report, but of course, with YouTube, we always look at bugs, so you'll want to go to youtube.com/dev and just log your bug there. We definitely look at all those. And if you do have any questions, you definitely want to send them to Stack Overflow, because we actually keep track of that. But for bugs, definitely look at that. And then there's, of course, the same question. We put the same question as a plug every week. Is YouTube developers live, or is YouTube developers hiring? And we are. Just go to developers.google.com/jobs and just have a look there if you're interested. Thanks again for coming. One more thing I'd like to point out is you were telling me you guys are a certain, aren't you rated on the top? You want to talk about that, your ratings?
Oh, sure. So we launched a fitness flow in time for the new year, and we've already seen it organically grow to be one of the top apps in free and paid for health and fitness category on Google Play. So I think right now on tablet we're in the top 10 in both free and paid. And our other application, Workout Trainer, is also up there as well, top 10.
Yeah, so if you don't remember, you'll see it when you look at the top downloads. Because actually that's where I found it when I was browsing around.
Excellent.
Before I started searching for your Skimble, so it was great. Pretty cool. But thanks for coming today. Thanks for talking about the Player API. Mm-hmm. And any other closing words?
No, I mean, just thank you for putting this out there. It's I think it makes life a lot simpler for Android developers.
Mm-hmm. Great. We're happy to help. And download the app. It's pretty cool. I've been playing with it. You'll get a workout.
One sit-up at a time.
One sit-up at a time. All right. Thank you for coming. And
thanks
sorry
for
again
us.
For the delay.
Bye.